All right, Editor Lover TV, spin back at y'all again tonight. once again, excuse my voice, it's hoarse. I told y'all my last blog earlier after my reaction to the Tony Harrison Charlo fight. But in this video, I'm going to talk about what I thought about a prospect that I've been having eyes on that I actually like and follow, was Effie Ajabo. And I want to speak on, you know, it was so good to see Spence out tonight. It was good to see Spence out, you know what I'm saying? That was like a highlight for the night for me seeing Spence, because, you know, Spence is like my favorite welterweight. I know a lot of people like Terrence Crawford and whatever, but I think Spence the baddest man in their weight division. But Epi Ajabo showed me tonight that boy, he needs some more work, man. I know he only got 11 fights. Well, 12 now. 12 fights. He needs some work, man. He had me worried for a second there, man. Like, he had me worried tonight. He was, you know, so he did his thing. He got the knockout. But what I was noticing about Effie Ajabo, what I noticed is that it looked like he needed to work on his footwork, man. And he make the same mistakes I be making. You know what I'm saying? When he throw his jab sometimes, he lean in forward. And when I do that, my trainer tell me that's not good, because he said you're putting your chin out there to get hit. And when he throw his jab, he be reaching a lot. You know what I'm saying? Instead of actually measuring and getting the distance down, so he won't have to lean in with that jab and throw them punches. Like, he kind of launches punches. And tonight, it almost cost him. You know, what his name? Largo Q. I ain't even about to try to pronounce the last name. Largo, the guy he fought tonight, he caught him, hurt Effie Ajabo, and dropped him. And it wasn't even like it was something like he was sharp. It was just more so like Ajabo was on his ass and hitting him and getting him. And he was just like trying to like just bang with him and threw some wild hooks and caught Effie. But y'all know this heavyweight boxing. The heavyweight hit you, man, on the chin, you know, that could change the tide of a fight. And it almost happened for Effie. I was kind of worried, man, because I got a lot of high hopes for Effie Ajabo. I like Effie. But it seemed like to me, like, he too much of a headhunter. Not one time tonight did I see Effie try to go to the body. Not once. He headhunted all night. Yo, Effie, man, you got to do more than just headhunt, bro. And you got to quit lunging in with your jab and with your punches, because that's going to fuck around and get you caught again. And the next time you get caught like that, man, you might not get back up, man. I think that's something that his trainers, and I hope they was watching tonight, and see the stuff they need to work on with Effie, man. Because Effie, I got high hopes for Effie, man. I think Effie can really be something. I really like Effie. He got power. He don't really got, like, massive speed like that, but he got power. So I'm saying his power kind of make up for everything, but that's not going to be enough. And the guy he fought tonight had like 26 fights, 20-some fights, something like that, I think. Yeah, a lot more experience than Effie. Effie only got 12 fights. Like I said, this was his 12th fight tonight. So I said that, and I'm like, damn, dude got a lot of experience. I'm going to see how Effie going to do against a guy like this with this much experience. I mean, he pulled it off, and I think he just pulled it off being the younger. I think being the younger fighter, the bigger fighter, the stronger fighter with the reach, it really helped him out tonight, man, because it was almost looking pretty bad for Effie, man. So hopefully, you know, his team looked at that stuff tonight and synced that stuff. And hopefully, you know, they go back to the drawing board and try to correct that for Effie, man. Because, like I said, I like Effie, and I want to see what he's going to be in the heavyweight division. But on another note, man, Spence came out tonight. My dog, Earl Spence, boy, the true junior, my boy EJ. And he was getting interviewed by that fucking Brian Kenny dude, whoever his name is, Brian Ken, whatever. That dude is fucking terrible, dog. Like, I'm watching an interview, and I'm mad for Spence. Like, the shit he was asking, how he was trying to be funny. Ask him a question, and he'd answer it. And then he'd turn right around and ask him the question again, trying to be funny and shit. Like, he was asking him about the accident and what was going on with him. He like, you know, I feel great. He like, yeah, I feel great. I started back training earlier this week. You know, I've been in the gym. I'll be coming back, you know, next year, you know, in May. And he could turn around and say, so you said you'll be coming back. So when you coming back next year, you say you'll be? He like, you know, I'm coming back in May. Then Brian King like, so you coming back in May? Yeah, motherfucker. He coming back in May. Like, how many times you got to say this shit? Then he asked him about the, you know, about what's going on as far as with his, you know, his legal concerns about, you know, with his crash and all of that. And, you know, he said he couldn't talk about it for legal reasons. And out of respect for, you know, his attorney and all of that, he turned right around and say, oh, so we ain't going to talk about the DUI. Like, just trying to put him out there, just trying to dog him and, like, trying to be funny, man. Like, I know Earl Spence wanted to punch the shit out of him in his fucking face because I wanted to blow his shit out. Like, man, I couldn't do them interviews. You know what I'm saying? I wouldn't make it far in that type of shit. Cause I've been a clip the nigga trying to be funny, dog. Like, you trying to be funny? You trying to be funny, nigga? You know what I'm saying? Then he asked him who he want. You know, he named everybody. I like how he said, you know, he mentioned Terrence Crawford. He like, I want all them guys, Terrence. Matter of fact, he actually said that he don't even want no tuna fight. He like, I don't want no tuna fight. I want to come straight back and get in with the best guys. Man, that boy, Earl Smith, got the biggest heart. Man, that boy a lion for real. What they call they some lion's den, that nigga, he the lion in they den, for real. And I was looking at him. I know y'all noticed the brie on my nigga, dog. Like, the cuts and the lip. Like, I saw that shit, man. And I'm like, I just kept thinking, like, damn, man. I hope when he come back that shit don't affect him. Because Earl Smith is the type of dude, he's so much of a warrior and an animal. And so confident, even if that shit really is affecting him. I'm not saying that it is. He said that it's not. I believe him. But I'm saying if it wasn't, he the type of dude that will, you know, say that it's not and just fight through it. And you would never know that he affected by it because he that much of a champion. Like, guys like Spence don't come around that often. Spence was one of them. I feel like Spence could have survived back in the day with them goons, back in the day, them thugs. Back in the 90s, early 90s, mid-80s, early. I feel like Spitz could have been back there with them because he an animal, man. He don't care. He'll fight anybody. Spitz ain't ducking nobody. He ain't ever ducked nobody. He want all the best fights, man. Spitz is that nigga, dog. He the truth. His name feel perfect. Spitz is the truth, dog. Like, real talk. You know what I'm saying? I do want to see the Terrence Crawford fight at Spitz. I just hope it don't get dragged out too long, like Manny Pacquiao and them did, and like how Deontay and Joshua going, like Joshua, and that's really Joshua's fault, but I just hope they don't get drugged. I hope they get the fight. I honestly don't think Terrence Crawford wants the fight, me personally. I don't think he wants the fight. Because when he re-signed with Top Rank the second time, and he knew all the good, where the big fights was at. He knew where the money fights was at, where he wanted to fight. He knew. And he went back there. That told me right there he don't want the fights. So can't nobody tell me shit about everybody ducking him and Spence ducking him. He didn't want the fights, dog. Because if he wanted the fights, he knew what the fuck he had to do to go over there. He stayed over there with Bob Arum. Because that's an excuse not to win. Because he don't really want them fights. You know what I'm saying? Terrence Crawford is a beast. He an animal. He's an animal. I know Phenom always say he consider him number one pound for pound fighter in the world. I don't. If he is, he's second to Spence. Flat out. Like I don't see how he can feel like somebody can feel like he pound for pound and he ain't really fought no competition like that. Like he ain't really fought nobody for real. Like he fought Benavidez, but Benavidez got one leg. He got one leg. That nigga ain't 100%. Been shot, all type of shit. Like, his resume not like Spence's resume. It's not. Their resumes are not the same. Spence had the better resume, man. You know what I'm saying? People want to criticize Spence, talking about, oh, that fight with Crawford was too, I mean, with Porter was too close. No, that was a good-ass fight, and it was close. But Spence won that fight. And you got to respect Spence for going in there. Spence went in there and fought his fight, his style, and beat him fighting his fight. He went in there and fought Sean Porter's fight and won. He got it knocked down and won the fight. When he fought Mikey Garcia, he didn't fight like that. He boxed Mikey Garcia. Because Mikey Garcia said that they were trying to say that he couldn't box. So he showed you that he can box. And then when he fought Sean Porter, he showed you that he can be a dog. He can out-dog you. Man, Spence is that guy, man. You know, I just hate that he had to have that whack-ass, bitch-ass interview by Brian Kenny. That was some bullshit. That shit had me mad as hell. You know what I'm saying? Brian Kenny is a fucking scumbag, man. You know, I gotta say scumbag and shit like that. I can't be ghetto and talk how I really talk. I wanna say he a whole ass nigga, bitch ass nigga and all that, but I ain't gonna do that. He a scumbag, man. He an asshole, man. You know, he ain't shit, man. I hope Spence never give him another interview again. I see why Floyd Mayweather don't like him and why Floyd went off on him back in the day when he interviewed him. Like, that dude trash, man. He pure trash. But all in all, man, I'm glad to see Spence back, man. I'm glad to see Spence, you know, healthy and he got his health. I'm glad that, you know, that could have been a lot worse. He could have lost his life. He could have been paralyzed or anything. I'm glad that it turned out. That just shows you right there. Y'all saw the accident. Y'all see the way that car was flipping over. That man survived that, boy. That boy got a heart of iron, man. That's willpower, man. That boy something special, dude. This ain't no dick riding shit, none of that. I just fuck with him. I'm a fan of that nigga because I'm a fan of boxing. And I think Spence is definitely one of my favorite boxers. Top three right now is Deontay Wilder, it's Errol Spence, and it's probably Javante Tank Davis. And Devin Haney, my guy, too. I really fuck with Devin Haney. You know what I'm saying? Like, them my guys. Like, them my guys right now. Javante, Devin, Deontay Wilder, Errol Spence. Them is my guys. And Hater to Love It TV, man, tell me what y'all think, man, about Spence and how y'all felt like he looked. Do y'all think he looked good? Do y'all think that, you know, when he come back, he going to be okay? I think he do. I want to think he do. I believe he is. And I want him to come back and I want him to be strong. And I don't want it to be nothing. Like I said, man, he said he don't need no tune-up. He coming back, he wants the biggest fights. Y'all heard what he said. Man, Hater to Love It TV signing out, man. I'm up out of here, man.